गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम फारिया बानो। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माई क्लास। हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एट योर होम। माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो वी वर डिस्कस अबाउट लेसन 5, जस्ट इमेजिन। नाउ वी आर गोइंग to discuss about our previous homework. Your previous homework was answer these questions with reference to the context. Your question is shown on your screen. First one, just imagine how many hankies there would have to wash and iron and fold. This is your reference to the context. Your question: A. Who would have to wash and iron the many hankies? B. Question: Why would they need so many hankies? Now it's time for your answer. Answer A. I'm repeating once again. Question A: Who would have to wash and iron the many hankies? Your answer is: An elephant had to wash and iron the many hankies. B. Question B is: Why would they need so many hankies? Your answer is: They need so many hankies because they sneezed every time or had a bad cold. This is your answer of your previous homework. Now we are going to discuss about second answer these questions with reference to the context. Your second one is, just imagine what a tangle of legs there would be if just one of those laces was not done up right. So we just go through your poem, you will get your answer, but here we are going to discuss the answer as well as questions also. First one, your second A question: Whose legs would be in a tangle? Whose legs would be in a tangle? Your answer is: Centipede's legs would be in a tangle. In a tangle. B. What laces are being talked about? What laces are being talked about? Laces of boots worn by the centipedes are being talked about. Your answer is: Laces of boots worn by the centipedes are being talked about. Now C, question C: Why would there be a tangle of legs? Your answer is: There would be a tangle of legs because there are so many legs. There are so many legs. Now, third, referring to the context, your question: If children like me had wings like birds, with which we could fly and soar up high, just imagine how many children there would be zooming about in the sky. I'm repeating it once again. If children like me had wings like birds, with which we could fly and soar up high, just imagine how many children there would be zooming about in the sky. Your question A is: How could children fly? How could children fly? Here, your answer is, if children had wings like bird, they could fly and soar up high. If children had wings like bird, they could fly and soar up high. Your question B is, what is the poet asking the reader to imagine? What is the poet asking the reader to imagine? Here, the poet asks the reader to imagine about how many children there would be zooming about in the sky. Here, the poet asks the reader to imagine about how many children there would be zooming in the sky. Now, see, here your question is, pick a word from the lines above which means to rise high in the air. Here you can see, if children like me had wings like bird with which we could fly and soar up high. Just imagine how many children there would be zooming about in the sky. Here we have to pick a word from these lines which means to rise high in the air. Here your answer is soar, S-O-U-R. It means soar up high in the air. My dear students, for you, I'm going to repeat once again your answers. Second one, just imagine what a tangle of legs there would be if just one of those laces was not done up right. Question A, whose legs would be in a tangle? Here, answer is centipede's legs would be in a tangle. B, what laces are being talked about? Answer is, laces of the boots worn by the centipedes are being talked about. Question C, why would there be a tangle of legs? Your answer is, there would be a tangle of legs because there are so many legs. 3, you can see the lines. From here, we have to write the answer. If children like me had wings like birds with which we could fly and soar up high. Just imagine how many children there would be zooming about in the sky. Here, my dear students, question A, how could children fly? If children like me had wings like bird, they could fly and soar up high. B question, what is the poet asking the reader to imagine? Here the poet asks the reader to imagine about how many children there would be zooming about in the sky. Question C, last one, pick a word from the lines above it means to rise high in the air. Pick a word from the lines. Here your lines is here, you can see, which means to rise up high in the air. Your answer is soar, S-O-U-R. It means to rise high in the air. Now it's time for your homework. You can see on your screen B, answer these questions. Your homework is question number 1 and 2. Question number 1 is, why would crocodile need a loads of toothbrushes? Question B, what would elephant have to do if they were to use handkerchief for their cold? These two questions are your homework. I wish you will do your homework at your home. Read once again poem Lesson 5, just imagine, you will get your answer there. Till that, thank you so much. God bless you.